Icy mountain peaks are beautiful to look at, but this harsh environment is at the mercy of some of the most powerful blizzards on Earth. In May 2005, three mountaineers, Eric Bjarnason, Alex Nigorowicz, and Don Jardine, were attempting to climb Mount Logan, Canada's highest peak. They were near the summit when a powerful blizzard struck. The climbers couldn't move in the blinding whiteout. They had no choice but to try and pitch a tent in the howling wind.
Think about being in back of a jet engine. Unless you huddled down on all fours, you would get blown away.
For 8 hours, the tent stood up to the storm, but finally, the tent began to tear away. All their survival gear was in the tent, so Eric held on as long as he could. But the blizzard was too strong. In seconds, the storm had taken everything they owned, leaving them stranded, exposed, and as good as dead. To make matters worse, in the chaos of the blizzard, Eric's thermal gloves had blown away. Without them, his hands became paralyzed with frostbite, leaving him helpless.
Don said, "Eric, stay here, we'll build a shelter, we'll come back for you if we can." And then they were gone. They talk about the phases of death, like I went through them all. Like I was angry at first, and then I started to bargain with God for my life, and finally accepted it.
But out in the blizzard, Don and Alex had not given up.
After about 5 to 6 hours, we got this snow cave built, which was more like a sardine can.
With the cave built, they found Eric, and together, the three men climbed into their freezing shelter.
It seemed like all you could do now was just to sit and wait to die, because the storm seemed like it wasn't going to peter out.
The storm raged on around the trapped climbers for 2 days. At last, a rescue helicopter was sent up into the now clear sky, and the men were brought down the mountain. The men spent months in the hospital before they recovered from their ordeal. Eric, who'd suffered 3 days in freezing temperatures with no gloves, lost 9 fingers to frostbite. The men had survived the full power of a blizzard, partly because they were experienced climbers who knew what to do, and partly because they were lucky.